James Weldon Johnson was born in 1871, and he left us in 1936. As you might probably know from the program or prior, he was the brother, poet brother, of the musician who together wrote the song we have just sung. He compiled a group of what he calls sermons under the title of God's Trombone, and this is one of those sermons, and it represents the sometimes almost literally the words that the old Baptist preacher said in a sermon to his congregation. This is one of the very famous ones of them. And God stepped out on space, and he looked around and said, "I'm lonely. I'll make me a world." And as far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything, blacker than 100 midnights down in a cypress swamp. Then God smiled, and the light broke, and the darkness rolled up on one side, and the light stood shining on the other side, and God said, "That's good." Then God reached out and took the light in his hands, and God rolled the light around in his hands until he made the sun, and he set that sun ablazing in the heavens. And the light that was left from making the sun, God gathered it up in a shining ball and flung it against the darkness, spangling the night with moon and stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world. And God said, "That's good." Then God himself stepped down, and the sun was on his right hand, and the moon was on his left, and the stars were clustered about his head, and the earth was under his feet. And God walked, and where he trod, his footsteps hollowed the valleys out and bulged the mountains up. Then he stopped and looked and saw that the earth was hot and barren. So God stepped over to the edge of the world. He spread out the seven seas. He batted his eyes, and the lightnings flashed. He clapped his hands, and the thunders rolled, and the waters above the earth came down. The cooling waters came down. Then the green grass sprouted, and the little red flowers blossomed, and the pine tree pointed his finger to the sky, and the oak spread out his arms, and lakes cuddled down in the hollows of the ground, and the rivers ran down to the seas, and God smiled, and a rainbow appeared and curled itself around his shoulder. And God raised his arms, and he waved his hands over the sea and over the land, and he said, "Bring forth, bring forth." Quicker than God could drop his hand, fishes and fowls and beasts and birds rammed the rivers and the seas, roamed the forests and the woods, split the air with the wings, and God said, "That's good." Then God walked around, and God looked around on all he had made. He looked at his sun. He looked at his moon. He looked at his little stars. He looked on his world with all its living things, and God said, "I'm lonely still." Then God sat down on the side of a hill where he could think. By a deep, wide river, he sat down with his head in his hands. God thought and thought till he thought, "I'll make me a man." Up from the bed of the river, God scooped the clay. And by the bank of the river, he kneeled him down. And there the great God Almighty, who lit the sun and fixed it into the sky, who flung the stars to the most corners of the world, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hand, this great God, like a mammy bending over her baby, kneeled down in the dust, tall and over a lump of clay, till he shaped it in his own image. Then he blew into it the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Amen, amen.